Hello everyone, welcome. Thank you for joining me. In this session, we're gonna focus on standing, moving our body and our torso. I have some weights here, they're 5 pounds each. You don't have to use weights. I recommend using no more than 5 or 7 pounds. Less is great, and again, you can always use none. Stand with your legs parallel hip distance. All they're gonna do is you're gonna bend one knee forward and twist your torso towards that side, growing tall. The toes can be on or off the floor. It's your choice, untwist or turn them the other way. This reciprocal pattern going side to side is really quite healthy for your neuromuscular system because we often operate in a side to side bilateral pattern in some way. Easy, breathe, grow tall, twisting. Eight, and then return. Again, the toes can stay on the floor, they can come off the floor, and they can go right back down. Seven, no big deal. Do try to make sure that the knee goes forward. So as I twist, the knee does not open out to the side with me, it goes forward directly. Easy, return. I grow tall and twist gently only as far as I have comfort. Your eyes and head can twist around a little more if you have comfort doing that. For unlike when we're like in like a plank or in a lunge and doing a twist with our body there, the effect of gravity on your neck can be really aggressive. Now that we're vertical, you can actually twist your neck a little further with less sense of strain to the neck going to its end range of motion just because of the orientation to gravity, right? It's a really nice thing to explore. Easy. Mm-hmm. One more time. Really good job. Easy. Twist and rotate. I'm going to take both hand weights into the same side and do the same thing. Easy. 10. It changes the emphasis quite a bit. You can feel that. Easy. Rotate. 9. Control. Toes on or off the floor. Your choice. Breathe deeply. 8. Try not to look down. Survey your terrain. Rotate. Breathe deeply. 7. Again, the knee bends forward. We're twisting towards it. Breathe deeply. 6. Take the arms and shoulders with you. Grow tall. Breathe deeply. 5. Knees facing forward gently. 4. The toes may not, but the knees try to. Breathe deeply. Rotate. 3. Action jump. Good work. Easy. Twisting. 2. Mm-hmm. One more time. You're doing really well. Now you know what's next. Congratulations. Put the weights in the other hand and just keep going. 10. Again, you can lift your toes off or you don't have to. Breathe deeply. 9. Get next to a wall. Balance is challenging. If you're a piece of furniture that's stable. 8. Easy. Chest and shoulders stay open. Breathe deeply. 7. So as I twist, try not to submit to gravity. 6. Be defiant. Breathe rebellious against the force downward. 5. Easy. Rotate across. Breathe deeply. 4. Excellent work, everyone. Control. Rotate. Breathe deeply. 3. Really nice job there. Easy. Rotating. 2. Mm-hmm. One more time. Control. Yeah. Take the weights back one each hand. Now all we're going to do, profile, is I'm just facing this way. As you can see, I'm just squatting. And then return. Hips go back. I lean forward. Take my focus with me. And push up to return. 9. Again, easy, gentle. We're going to breathe deeply. 8. It's a great motion to practice. 7, it's like a sitting motion, so that's excellent. 6, easy, can't practice it enough, breathe deeply. 5, it really encourages from your ankle, knee, and hip, 4, to communicate with each other, it's really helpful, breathe deeply. 3, think of the top of your foot coming to the front of your shin, 2, so your ankles are quite active here, right? Now you know both weights go to one hand. Here we go, shoulder stays open. Now, because again, as you bend specifically, your body's getting pulled forward by gravity and the weight. So, you've got to resist that. 8, make sure you don't shift the hips off to the side. 7, because the weight is pulling you. 6, you've got to resist that. Hips go back, shoulder stays open. Breathe deeply. 5, good work there. Control. Nice, everyone. 4, excellent. 3 more. You can do this. Breathe. Take your eyes in focus with your chest, wherever your chest faces. 3, that's where your eyes look. Breathe deeply. 2, shoulders stay wide and open. Other side, you got it. You take a break. You can always press pause. 10, if my tempo or pace or just whatever is too much, take a momentary break for yourself. 9, join me when you're ready. 8, that's always great. Easy. Knees go forward. 7, make sure the knees don't come together or apart. 6, just go forward. Again, your toes may not face forward. 5, they don't have to, but the knees try to generally. 4, maybe not specifically, you know, not like a laser beam. They can go out to the side a little bit, repeatedly too, but generally, you gotta weight each hand. Now, as I bend one knee, I'm gonna bend my body towards that side, keeping my eyes off the floor, and then return. Bend the other knee. My head goes over to the same side of the knee, lifts, 9. And then to vertical. Again, bend the lip, This is a harder version, 8, specifically because we're changing the orientation of our eyes, 7, and our vestibular system. So your face and head, basically, 6. Easy breathe. Control. Gentle. 5. Again, toes can be on or off the floor or a bit of both. 4. Really great job. Hips do shift over to the side. 3. Make sure you have comfort and control. Breathe deeply. 2. Right, we're not hanging out there too long. You're welcome. Easy. Don't make it so very deep. Now you know both weights go to one hand. That's gonna make it harder in one way, and it's gonna make it different and more challenging in the other. 9. Take your time. Make sure you have no pain or strain to your joints. 8. It's a way too much for this exercise. Use ladder weights. 7. Use no weights. Chest and eyes up. Breathe deeply. 6. Fantastic. Easy. Breathe. 5. Nice, everyone. You're doing great. Keep breathing. 4. Inhale, exhale freely and joyfully. 3. Balance is key. Coordination is fun. 2. Really great to exercise with those two concepts in mind. Now, other side, you know what's going to happen. You lift the knee. You bend your head towards it. You bend your head towards the same side as knee lifts. 9. Body stays looking forward in space. 8. Try not to look down. Breathe deeply. 7. That affects your posture and your alignment. Look forward. 6. And again, keep that shoulder open. 5. The weight and gravity tends to pull the shoulder forward here. 4. So be aware of that. Easy. Breathe. 3. Excellent work there. Control. 2. Yeah, not so bad. Easy. 3. Over before you know it's true. Now, one weight each hand. I have one leg forward, other leg back. My legs are just hip distance, right? So I'm not crossed. One forward, one back, hip distance apart. Now, both knees bend, my hips go forward and down. Try not to lean forward here. So this is not a squat, this is a lunge kind of thing. Not that the name's important, but we're not leaning forward here, which is gonna be the tendency for a lot of people. The hips have to go forward and down, back and up. 8. The back heel can lift because the hips are going forward and down. 7. Versus lifting the back heel to get the hips to go forward and down. Different things, right? So allow it to lift, but it's not the focus, right? Hips going forward and down is the focus. 5. Great job there. Easy. Gentle. Shoulders stay open. 4. Really good job there. Control. Breathe deeply. 3. Excellent work. Control. Take your time. 2. Remember which leg is forward. Note that because we're switching sides. Other leg forward. You can always hit pause. Hips go forward and down and then return back. Good. Again, forward and down. 9. Make sure you only bend your joints. 8. As far as you have no pain or strain. Gentle. Breathe deeply. 7. Take your time. Shoulders stay open and wide. Breathing. 6. Only go as far as you have comfort, which may not be as far as I'm showing here. 5. Sorry. Counting's atrocious. Apologies. 4. Really great job. Control. Chest and shoulders stay open. 3. Really good job. Control. Breathe deeply. 2. Now, note which leg is forward because we're going to go to the other side. I'm going to put both weights in the same side of the front leg. Now, as we bend, you know, we're going to add things together. I'm going to twist towards that front leg and then return. Twisting towards the front leg. 9. The weight's in the same side hand as front leg. I'm twisting towards it. 8. It's the same thing, just with a rotation. Rotate and spiral, bending. 7. Good, everyone. Untwist. Control. Bending. 6. Chest up, eyes up, shoulders wide. Shoulders wide. 5. Does not mean squeeze your waist together in the back. 3. Just make sure you're not having the shoulders go forward. 4. Or back markedly. Wide. 3. Like you have antennae coming from either shoulder, and they survey the sides of the room. 2. Not the front or the back. They go out to the sides. Easy breathe. Now, note which leg is forward. We're going to the other side. The same side arm as leg that's forward has the weights. Bend both knees. Twist towards that side. Untwist. Heel down. The back heel can lift. 9. But then it's got to return down. Breathe deeply. Rotate. Breathe deeply. 8. Good, everyone. Untwist. Return. Beautiful. Bend. Twist. Spiral. 7. Action job. Return. Keep breathing. Rotate, twist, 6. Good, everyone. And then return. Beautiful. Again, rotate, twist, 5. Action job. Control. Breathe deeply. 4. Feel all the stimulation that weight provides your body. Breathe deeply. 3. What a lovely thing to experience. Easy. Rotate, twist, 2. One more time. Great job. Again, note which leg is forward. Now, I'm going to have the other leg forward, and the weights are now on the opposite side hand of front leg. As I bend both knees, I'm twisting towards my back leg. And then return. Take your time. Twist towards that back leg. 9. Body still stays perpendicular, so try not to lean forward here. 8. As you go along, you're going to only go as far as you have comfort and no strain. 7. And you keep that alignment. Body perpendicular. 6. Hips go forward and down. Hips go forward and down. 5. Good work, everyone. Control. Hips go forward and down. 4. Really nice work. Control. Breathe deeply. 3. Eyes and chest up. Keep the back of that front heel bone glued to the floor. 2. The whole time, you'll feel that when that front heel lifts, things change, and not often for the better. Now, switch sides. Right? My hand, opposite hand of front leg, has the weights. As I bend both knees, I twist towards the back leg side. And this might feel quite different going this way. That's fine. No big deal. Twist. Eyes up. 9. Try not to look down to the floor. Hips go forward and down. 8. And then return. Great job. Hips go forward and down. Rotate. 7. Nice control, everyone. Easy. Breathe. Rotate. Spiral. 6. Action. Jump there. Again, shoulders wide. Twist. Eyes up. 5. Look away from the floor. Good. Twist as you bend. 4. Excellent work, everyone. Control. Twist as you bend. 3. Look away from the ground. Shoulders wide. Back heel can lift. 2. But then put it down. One more time. Again, easy. Breathe. Oh, that was so stimulating. Now, I'm going to have one foot in front of the other like I'm on a tightrope. If that doesn't feel good, have the feet a little wider apart until you find your comfort level. Weight either hand. As I bend my knees, I bend my head to one side. Straighten your legs. Return. I'm going to go the other way. Bend both knees again. Head goes the other way. Keep the back of both heel bones on the floor. 9. And then return. Knees bend. Side bending. Eyes up. 8. Chest up. Look away from that floor. Knees bend. Side bend. 7. Good, everyone. And then return. Breathe. Knees bend. Side bend. 6. Really powerful. Take your time. Bending. Stretching. 5. Let your head and neck go with you. Only go as far as you have comfort. Breathe deeply. 4. Whew, the balance is so fun. Again, easy. 3. Excellent work, everyone. 2 more there. Easy. 2. One more time. Lots of balance. Oh, that's so good. And then return. Switch your legs. Again, my legs aren't too far apart front to back, right? Having them closer together is much more challenging than having them a little further apart front to back. And again, step wider apart to make it easier for you. Knees face forward, toes may not. Keeping the back of the heel bones on the floor, bend your knees, head tilts to one side, let your body bend a bit, straighten to return. Keep the back of the heel bones on the floor, 9, and only bend as far as you have control. You may find that you bend a bit more on one side, 8, than the other, that's fine. Again, easy, breathe, 7, maybe bend less on the side you're bending more on, breathe deeply, 6, until you feel more stable, so on the side that's harder, you can try lengthening more out to the side, 5, once you've gained some practice, easy. So don't go big on one side, small on the other, 4, they're either both small or both large, but they're trying to be the same-ish. 3. Keep the back of the heel bone on the floor. You're going to have more weight to your back leg than front leg here, 2. That's normal. Easy breathe. Yeah. Excellent job. Now you know what's next. The weight goes in one hand. I'm choosing the same side hand as front leg. You don't have to. Feel free to use no weights. Here's that tightrope stance again. Bend your knees. Bend to one side and then return. And then bend your knees to the other side. 9. Take your time, easy. Bending to the side, 8. Let your head and neck go with you. Take your time, 7. And then return. Keep the back of the heel bones on the floor. 6. Nice and tall with your chest. Breathe deeply, 5. If all this is too challenging, have yourself with a pole in one hand, 4 or 2 hands, with a rubber tip or your pole in a shoe with a rubber shoe on the floor, with a rubber sole on the floor. 3. Easy to make it less intense. 2. Easy breathe. Ooh, one more time. Now you have options here. I'm going to choose to switch everything, right? That just makes more sense to me, but you can just switch one element, right? Maybe just the legs and keep the weights on that side. Here we go. Bend your knees, torso bends, straighten to return. Heels stay down. Knees go forward, gently, 9, and then return. Toes may not face forward. Keep those heels down, 8. Try not to grip the floor with your toenails like talons. Breathe deeply, 7. Instead, pour more weight to the very back of the heel bone. Breathe deeply, 6. That will help more of your whole leg engage fully. Breathe deeply, four, versus biasing when you grip your toes into the back of your lower leg. Breathe deeply, three, easy. Two more, breathe deeply, two. That went by so fast, I agree. Now, I'm going to switch just one element. I'm gonna switch my legs only, right? Now I have the weight to the opposite side of front leg and I bend my body one way, then bend my knees, and then return, and then bend the other way. Take your time. Nine, knees go forward, woo, take your time. Eight, so stimulating, breathe deeply. Bending, seven, and then straightening, return. Bending, six, straight and return, great. Feet can be further apart, five, either side to side and or front to back, four, both will make it less intense. Three, the closer they are together, the more intense the balance is. Two, easy breathe. Somehow I think I have one more to go. Let's do one more in case I'm wrong, because that is frequently the case. Great job, nice work. So I have opposite hand and foot forward. So when I switch, I have to switch everything to make sure I'm doing the same thing all the way around. It's our last round already. Bend your knees and torso, heel bones on the floor, and then return. Bend gently, nine, and then return. Take your time. Breathe deeply, eight, shoulders wide. Take your time, bending, seven. Knees go forward the whole day there. Breathe deeply, six. Keep the back of the heel bone on the ground. Breathe deeply, five. Excellent work, everyone. Take your time, bending, four, and then straightening. Excellent work. Bending, three. Easy, look away from the floor. Bending, oh, two. Oh my God, almost fell there. Well, fell, fall is an exaggeration. Almost had to step out. Uncross your legs, weights each hand. Great job. Now, all you're gonna do is you're gonna bend your knees and just bring your chin to your chest. Do not go further down. Your head stays above your chest. Breathing in. Push to return up nice and tall. And again, bend your knees, chin to chest. Just let your arms dangle forward. Stay here, take a deep breath in. And exhale up tall. Now take both weights to one hand or just drop a weight. So you can have one hand with one weight or two weights or no weights. But you're unevenly weighted. Chin to chest, bend your same thing. Head stays above the level of your chest. Stay here, breathing in. Push the floor down, roll all the way up tall. One more time. Again, breathing, bend your knees, chin to chest to curl. Stay forward, take a deep breath in. Push to bring it up tall. Now switch, the other hand has the weight, whatever it is, or no weight, chin to chest, bend to curl. Stay, deep breath in. Push through your legs, roll up nice and tall, head heavy, eyes from the left, one more time. Bend your knees, curl, round your spine. Stay here, take a deep breath in, really good everyone. Push to grow all the way up nice and tall, and rest. Excellent work. So there you have it. A really quick and efficient way to get your basic movements, so your balance done, your coordination, so your whole neuromuscular system is stimulated, but also your heart rate and lungs are a little stimulated, right? We also have some bone density as a target. It's not the heaviest weight, right? But it is strengthening and lifting more weight than you usually do will really encourage your bone density to fire up strongly. I hope you enjoyed this. My name is Eric. This is Nucleus Strength. I look forward to getting stronger with you in the future. Yours in good health. Take care.